So this is an exhibition that Sehmat has put in to commemorate with the 75th anniversary of India's independence. And through the last 30 years of Sehmat's existence, we have marked some of the iconic movements in the freedom struggle. So the idea is to not so much to celebrate, but also to underscore the path that we have taken to get the freedom. And the title of the exhibition, India is Not Lost, is taken from a letter that Mahatma Gandhi had written, or a speech that he had made when he was in Noakhali. And he had said, if Noakhali is lost, India is lost. This is Madhukar Upadhyay, who is a senior journalist. He wrote this text for the Dandi March project that we had done. This image is from a series we had done on commemorating the struggle for freedom, and this was essentially to mark the adoption of the constitution. So it's connected with that. This is an image by Pablo. These are all postcards that were done for this, and this Red the Earth that year contains material on 1857. Quite a lot of that is also displayed in an exhibition that you will see towards the end of this walk. And this also has a seminal article by Professor Irfan Habib on the significance of 1857. These are all the publications that we have brought out, marking the major landmark events. This is, you can obviously see, this is a spinning wheel. So the connection with Mahatma Gandhi and the entire movement of Swadeshi. This has been put together by Kanishk Prasad and Vartika Chaturvedi. And if you move this slowly, you can see large number of these postcards that were part of this project, Letters to Gandhi. So you can see the faded image of Mahatma Gandhi, which were actually postcards brought out on, and on this Atul Dodia has done this work. This is a work by Vivan Sundaram, and it's this is the one foot of Mahatma Gandhi, and this is symbolically the salt satyagraha at Dandi. Work by Ram Rahman. This is when cutouts were being taken to be placed somewhere. This is Gargi Raina, and you can clearly see this is saffron. So, you know, what is happening to saffron and the land of saffron? This was another project called Making History Our Own. So this is, this was a long work. So we have taken a section of that. This is Jairam Patel. This is again a very interesting work. This is Mahatma Gandhi putting the broken pieces together. And the text on top says, Dehshat, Khauf, Azadi, Jihad, Aman. And you have, you know, images of guns and so on and so forth. This is a very interesting work. Most of the major figures of the freedom struggle appear in this together. So this was part of the Rejuvenate, Defend the Constitution of India at 70. But what is happening to the people for whom the Constitution is being made? Postcard project. Yeah. This is done by an artist who is Bombay-based, Jahangir Jani. Jallianwala Bagh. And you must have heard what they have done to the narrow street. You know, people actually were made to crawl on their elbows, those who were going to pay respects to those who had been killed. at Jallianwala Bagh for several days. And now that street has been turned into a kind of a mural with people laughing and as if they were going to join a mela. And that, earth-packed street has now been given a cover of glazed tiles. You know, so all traces and even many of the gunshot wounds, marks on the walls, they have been all dressed up and, you know, given a makeover. This is some of the original artworks for the project called Gift for India. And this was done on the 50th anniversary of India's freedom. We had asked 100 artists from across the world to send gifts for India. And we had given them the dimensions, 9 cm by 9 cm cube. And they had to work within that. So these kind of phenomenal range of works that people created. So this is the exhibition on 1857. And this is a translation of a Kumaoni song. Red the blood that flowed, red the fire that burned, red the sword, red the hand that held it, and red the earth in that amazing year. In that amazing year. This was Azimullah Khan. He wrote a song about 1857. He was an associate of Nana Sahib of Bithur. Most of these sketches are from a book that the English brought out in 1858 on the Sepoy Mutiny. And these were actual events. Each regiment used to have a regimental artist and they will keep on drawing sketches. So these were lithographs or etchings which were part of that publication. They've been taken from there. This is the point of revolt in 1857 in Meerut. There used to be this bridge that used to be placed every year, the bridge of boats, and the rebel soldiers crossed this bridge to reach Red Fort on 11th of May. So the major events that happened in the first couple of days, they are there. And then there is a large number of panels that carry the text of a public announcement that Bahadur Shah Zafar had made. So images of that period and the text connecting this Farman, the royal order was issued on the 25th of August 1857. This is probably Chavdi Bazaar. This map, the darkened area was where large-scale demolition took place in Delhi after the British had taken over. From here, from the fort wall to this line, this is 500 yards. They had issued orders that nobody will live in these 500 yards because they were afraid of another rebellion. And since now they were inside the fort, they wanted to make sure that anybody approaching the fort can be picked up and shot. So this entire area was, people were given 24 hours to vacate, and then the entire thing was dynamited and leveled. So the open, large open ground that you see in front of the Red Fort was created in 1858. This is actually the work of more than 30 years, and virtually hundreds of artists have contributed to this. And this is to underscore the long struggle to achieve freedom, which is the basic freedoms, the right to express to live peacefully, whether they are people, to have a constitution, to have a constitutional democracy, all of which is under serious threat right now. So it is important in that sense also, aside from the commemoration, it is important for people to come, see this exhibition, spread the word, because unless we stand up and to guard this freedom, it is not going to last.